T.N. Seshan, the former Chief Election Commissioner of India, passed away on Sunday after a cardiac arrest. The man was hailed as a legend for introducing model code of conduct in Indian elections and for always practicing and encouraging free and fair polls. The man was known for invoking fear in the minds of politicians and was strictly against misuse of any political power during polls. The Congress, which stood fourth in the state of Maharashtra with 44 seats, now stands as a key to form a non-BJP government in the state of Maharashtra. Amid the power tussle, Shiv Sena now expects and awaits an official confirmation from both the Congress and the NCP, while BJP has staked claims against forming a government for adequate numbers in Maharashtra. Another major news coming in today, no claimants for about a dozen dormant Swiss bank accounts linked to Indians have come forward to claim funds which lie at the risk of getting transferred to the Switzerland government. The Swiss government decided to maintain a detailed record of all these accounts back in 2015, where they allowed people to submit proof and get access to the funds, of which 10 accounts belonged to Indians. The claimable period for these accounts are likely to expire the next month. After the much-awaited Ayodhya verdict, CJI Ranjan Gogoi is still left with four major judgments to be delivered before he retires. The first is the Sabarimala Temple review. The second is the Rafael review. Third is the contempt case filed by Meenakshi Lekhi against Rahul Gandhi. And fourth is the decision whether CJI should come under the RTI.